In this lesson, I'm going to cover security groups and network ACLs. These are both types of firewall that we can use on AWS to protect our EC2 instances and databases and other services that sit inside an Amazon VPC. Now, firstly, I need to cover the difference between what we call a stateful and a stateless firewall. So here we have a web server on the left-hand side and a client on the right-hand side who wants to access that web service. And you can see the IP addresses associated with these two different computers. So what happens is, because it's a web server, it's going to listen on port 80. That's the well-known port for the unsecured version of HTTP. So the connection goes over at port 80, and there's a source port. Now, the source port is dynamically allocated by the operating system of the client. And it's a high numbered port, so it's not one of the well-known ports which sits somewhere between 1 and 1024. It's one of the high numbered ports. It's dynamically assigned, so we never know what it's going to be, but there always has to be a source port and a destination port, as well as a source IP and a destination IP. Now, the web server will receive the traffic and then it's going to respond. In this case, we swap things around, so the source port becomes 80, the destination 65188 in this case. So here we can see these two different traffic flows. Okay, the first one, the top one, that is coming from the client to the web server. We've got the source, IP address, destination IP, source port, and the destination port. And then we swap things around for the connection that's going back again. So we can see there are two different connections, but we know that they're actually related. Now, a stateful firewall will allow that return traffic automatically. So in other words, if there's a rule that allows the inbound traffic to reach the web server on port 80 from this particular client or any client, for example, then any return traffic that needs to go back to that client is going to be automatically allowed. In the case of a stateless firewall, these are two completely unrelated traffic flows. Both traffic flows require a separate rule to allow that traffic to pass. So this takes us to security groups and network ACLs. These are two different types of firewall that we can use in a VPC. Let's get started with the network ACL first. Network ACL is a network access control list, and they're applied at the subnet level. They screen the traffic that comes into the subnet and the traffic that's leaving the subnet. They don't see any traffic that's staying within the subnet between different instances. So NACLs apply at the subnet level, and they only apply to traffic entering or exiting the subnet, ingress and egress traffic. Now, security groups, on the other hand, are assigned at the instance level. Strictly speaking, they're actually attached to the elastic network interface of the adapters connected to your instance. Security groups can be applied to instances in any subnet. We can see here that security group A and B are applied to instances across different subnets. Now, back to stateful versus stateless, the security group is a stateful firewall. That means it will allow return traffic if the inbound traffic is allowed. Network ACLs, on the other hand, are stateless firewalls. So there you have to apply the rules in both directions for inbound traffic and outbound traffic in order for it to work. So let's just compare the two here. Security groups operate at the instance level. Network ACLs operate at the subnet level. So security groups will filter traffic that's going between instances in the same subnet, whereas the ACL will not do that. Security groups only support allow rules. That means everything is denied, and then you have to create allow rules for the traffic that you do want to allow. On the other hand, network ACLs support both allow and deny rules. So you can have a series of allow rules and then a deny rule that says everything else is denied, for example. The security group is stateful, and the network ACL is stateless. Security groups evaluate all rules to see if there is an allow for the specific traffic, whereas the network ACL processes the rules in order, so they're actually in a numbered order. And when it reaches a rule that either allows or denies the traffic, it just stops the processing right there. It either allows or denies the traffic at that point, regardless of whatever rules might come after that particular rule. Security groups apply to instances if they're associated with the security group, whereas network ACLs basically apply to every instance in the subnet that they're associated with. I'm in the EC2 management console, and I'm going to head down to security groups, and I'm going to create a security group called SG1. So we've got SG1, I'll put the same in the description, and I'm simply going to add a rule for SSH for management purposes from anywhere. And this is in my default VPC. Now, the outbound rule will allow the initiation of traffic outbound. This is a stateful firewall, so a security group will allow the response to any traffic that comes inbound. So in fact, I can SSH to this instance, even if I delete the outbound rule. Let's try that. Let's remove the outbound rule, and for inbound rules, we'll just leave SSH from anywhere and create the security group. So now I'm going to launch an instance. This is all in my default VPC. So we'll call this one instance one. And let's come down. I don't need a key pair because I'm going to use instance connect. Select a security group. I'm going to choose SG1. And that's all I need to do. Launch the instance. And then once the instance is running, I'm going to connect to it using instance connect. And we're going to test what we can do. The instance is running. Let's select the instance and choose connect. And let's see if we can connect using the EC2 user. So that's worked. I am now connected to the instance because I have the rule allowing the inbound traffic. So that's not been a problem. Now, of course, there is two-way traffic happening here between the instance connect and the instance itself within my VPC. But the return traffic is being allowed. Now, what if I try to do the ping google.com? Now, it's not going to work. Okay, I cannot do that because it's not going to allow that traffic outbound. So let's go back to security groups and select SG1 and then go to outbound rules, edit, and let's add a rule. And this one is going to be ICMP IPv4 to any IPv4 address. Let's save that. Let's come back and see. Now we can ping google.com. Okay, so the only traffic that I can initiate outbound is going to be to google.com. If I try to curl google.com, this is going to use, I've got to put http://. That's not going to work. It's just going to hang. Okay, it's not actually completing. And that's because I'm not allowing HTTP outbound. So now what I need to do is edit inbound rules and outbound rules and add HTTP to anywhere. Let's come back and see if we can curl. Okay, now we get a response. Okay, so we are actually able to use the HTTP protocol. So remember, when you're initiating outbound connections, you need to have rules. Typically, we have that rule in there, the default rule, which allows all traffic. Okay, so it's all traffic, here it is, to any destination. Okay, so that means I can now initiate all outbound connections. However, this particular server is now only allowing inbound connections on port 22. So let's test this out. I'm going to go and we're just going to run this. This is the user data simple website. Now, I didn't add this at launch, but what I'm going to do instead is I'll show you how to just turn this into a simple script. I'm going to change to sudo so that I've got some more permissions. And what we're going to do is nano a shell script. So let's call it userdata.sh. Paste this in. I'm going to save it using nano. So now I have this file. And what I want to do is chmod plus x file name to make it executable. And then we're going to run ./userdata.sh. Okay, so that should, it's going to update the Linux patches. Then it's going to install Apache and we should have a website. There we go, that's done. Okay, so let's just clear the screen. So what I should be able to do is change to var www HTML. And oh, in fact, the new, what happens with the latest version of Apache, there's no actual index.html here. It's part of the configuration of the web server, but it will show me an it works message if I connect to this website. However, in this case, it won't work. And that's because we don't have a security group rule. So of course, if I come back, select the public IP, and then let's go to browser window and it's just hanging again. Sure. Sign that it's a security group issue if the connection doesn't complete. It doesn't error, it's just kind of not going anywhere. All right, so of course what we need to do for that is come back to security groups, choose SG1, edit inbound rules, add a rule, and for this it's going to be HTTP from any source address. Okay, now I just stop that, let's try it again. Now it works. Okay, so we've got that message from Apache. So that's all working great. Now let's bring another instance into the mix and we're going to have a separate security group. So we're going to have the SG2 security group. And what we're going to do here is we're not going to allow any inbound rules in the beginning. Let's just create the security group and let's launch an instance And this one is going to be also, well, in fact, I'll call this one instance 2 so we can identify it nice and easily. And scroll down with the defaults left in place, proceed without a key pair. Default VPC, I'm going to select SG2 and then launch. What I want to do now is for instance 2, I'm going to copy its private IP address. And from the console of instance 1 here, let's just change back to our root directory just to clear things up a bit. And what I'm going to do is ping that instance. Now, you know that I'm allowing outbound traffic. I can ping google.com, but of course, there's no rule on the other end. So what we want to do is I'm going to do this the most secure way possible. I don't really want everyone on the internet to ping my instance or to be able to. What I want is for instances in SG1 security group to be able to ping the instance. So the way I'm going to do that is to come to the SG2 security group, and I'm going to add an inbound rule. So on inbound rules, edit, add a rule, and it's going to be ICMP, IPv4. And this time I'm going to type SG, and we can see security groups. So I'm going to choose SG1. So what I'm doing now is I'm allowing inbound traffic on ICMP IPv4 protocol from members of this security group only. Okay, so we've locked it down. Let's rerun that ping command, and now it works fine. So we call the security group chaining. We essentially set the inbound traffic to be allowed only from another security group. We can do the same with outbound traffic as well. So for example, I could lock down the security group 1 to only be able to send to security group 2 in this rule. I'd have to delete that outbound rule, add in 1 for ICMP, and set the destination to the security group. So security group chaining, very useful feature. Okay, that all looks good. Let's switch sites to using network access control lists. For this, we're going to head over to the VPC management console. And under security here, we've got network ACLs as well as security groups. So let's have a look at what we've got here. We've got this one with 6 subnets. That's the one in my default VPC. So here we can see that we have inbound rules. The rules with NACLs are in a numbered order. Okay, so rule number 100 in this case is the only rule. Then there's a star, which is kind of like a wild card at the end of the set of rules. Now, the first matching rule applies. In this case, all traffic from all protocols, all ports, and all sources will be allowed. So the deny doesn't really take effect at all. So what we can do is we can add rules with different numbers. Let's add rule 101, which says that all traffic from any source is denied. And what do you think that's going to do? Can I still refresh the page to this web server? It's refreshing, it's fine, it's working, it's not a problem. Is Instance Connect still working? Yep, not a problem. So of course, because of the numbered order, 101 is not being processed because the match is happening at rule 100. So what happens if I change that rule to 99? Now the order flips. Now 99 is first. What's going to happen when I refresh this page? It's gone. What about Instance Connect? I'm pressing enter. Nothing's happening. Okay, it's all dead now. So I've just restricted access completely. So that's the way that NACLs work. Otherwise, they're very similar in the case of we have to set the traffic that we want, which protocols, which ports, the source and the destinations. There's no security groups here for sources. It is IPs that you're going to utilize. So you have the option of just adding in the IP here as an open range or something more specific, right down to an individual IP address. So for example, you can have a deny rule for a specific IP address. Let's just assume this is a valid IP address on the internet, slash 32. That's an individual IP address. All 32 bits are masked. So that would be a match for that particular computer on the internet. So that's how you can use network ACLs. Now remember that these are stateless. Okay, so you need to have a rule for both directions. So I've just removed the rule that I added before. And let's go and have a look at outbound. So outbound, basically the same as inbound. It's allowing everything at the moment. So it's allowing all inbound connections and all outbound connections. Remember that if you add a rule allowing a protocol inbound, you have to make sure that is allowed outbound. It is in this case by default. But if you remove this rule 100, you're going to break everything because you must allow the traffic that goes outbound. That's even if it's in relation to inbound traffic. It's the response traffic from an inbound connection. Doesn't matter. The network ACL treats it separately. Okay, so that's a quick overview of network ACLs and security groups. And all I need to do now to clean up this lab is simply terminate these two instances.